Hi YouTubers, this is just a quick rundown on my little solar project. This is a little box I put together with some solar chargers and some monitoring equipment. Basically the idea behind it was to actually build a little solar power station which would act as a backup in case of a power outage. It's developed a little more than that since I've kind of gone into researching what kinds of solar panels operate best under certain conditions. I'll give you a quick rundown on the box and what's on it. We'll start on the top. Here you can see the reflection's not that great, but it's a Stecker solar charger. It's very nice in that the display, if you run through it, gives you the state of charge of your batteries. I know it's not coming out too well on the camera, but it gives you the kind of amperage and what have you that's coming in from the solar panels. Here I've got a power analyzer pro, which also gives you I've got three inputs for different solar panels because I'm hoping to compare three solar panels. At the moment I've only got two. I've got a crystalline and an amorphous panel. I want to get a CIGS panel so I can do the comparison there. But this shows the total figures coming in from all of the panels connected. So it shows you amps, the wattage, the watt hours, and the volts. Then over here, just as a quick note, it's quite handy because what it can do, you can actually record to a PC if you want to. I've got a module on there which allows you to record to PCs. I've got a small Xantrax modified sine wave inverter. It's a 400 watt just to as emergency power. Then this is obviously a kilowatt plug which can show you the power that you're using from the inverter. Inside the box I've got three 12 amp hour batteries, so it gives you about 36 amp hour or so total power available. I've also got this little light on the front, which is it's an LED strip light, which is quite nice. So it's not a fluorescent, it uses less power obviously, and comes on immediately and is far more robust. On the front here I've got three WhatsApp meters, and each of those is assigned to a different panel. You can see the one which is set to the 6 PV has got, basically, it can see the voltage, the total voltage, but it's got no power coming in because there's no 6 panel. That I'm hoping is going to come in the future. Then I've got one for the crystalline PV, and at the moment, the conditions outside, it's actually snowing, and it's part of the exercise to see how well the panels perform under challenging conditions, i.e. covered in snow and low temperatures and low light. That amorphous PV is actually, you can see that it's showing at the moment it's producing 1.9 watts. It's got 21 volts coming in with a few amps, it's like 0.09. And then you get a screen which flicks through and gives you totals, total watt hour, amp peak, your volts minimum, watts peak. Now, the interesting thing is, I've since upgraded and slotted on the SunSaver MPPT, Maximum PowerPoint Tracking Controller. And what that does is, as opposed to the Stecker controller, which is on top, this goes and tracks the maximum PowerPoint. So the problem with a normal controller is that it gets tied down to your battery voltage, and a solar panel can basically supply, let's say, 18, 20, 20 plus volts, and that by the spec amperage gives you a power rating for a panel. But if your panel is being pulled down to your battery voltage, you're going to lose the potential power that's available there. So if you've got a panel which can produce 20 volts at 1 amp, that's let's say it's a 20 watt panel as an example. If you're pulling that down to 12 volts, you've only got the 12 times the 1 amp, so there's potential power being lost. And what this does it tracks that the best power point and adjusts the voltage up and does a conversion to get you the right voltage for your battery. And during that conversion, because there's no loss in power, it converts that extra voltage into amps, which means you've got more power at the end of the day going into your battery or whatever application. And that's actually easy demonstrated. If I come back over here, you can actually see on that amorphous panel, it's showing 21 volts at the moment. And if I flick it across to the other controller, that drops right down to 13.5, which is where the battery's at. So you can easily lose up to 30% of your power. So if I go back again, you'll see it goes up to 21, which means you're getting more power in at the end of the day. So that's a quick rundown of the box. There are going to be a few more updates to it, as I'm going to be adding the CIGS panel. So only the two panels are bringing in power at the moment, and it's basically on an experiment to see which panel performs under what conditions. The crystalline panel, which is, as you'll see when I take you outside, is a lot smaller than the amorphous panel. It's smaller and lighter, but it suffers under low light conditions, and if there's any covering or shading on it, if there's any coverage of the panels, the output drops dramatically, as I've discovered through logging and testing. It can lose under the same kind of covering on the amorphous PV. The amorphous PV will put out four times the power of the crystalline if there's partial covering of them. So the amorphous certainly performs better in that regard. But the amorphous panel is a bigger, heavier panel for the same size wattage. They're both 50 watts, but as you'll see outside, there's quite a big size difference. And the amorphous one actually performs a little worse when it's colder, which is unusual. I hadn't realized that would be the case, but the amorphous panel actually performs better in under a little warmer conditions, up to a certain point. I think up to 20 degrees centigrade it performs better, whereas a crystalline one under the cold, and that's why it tends to put more power when it's cooler. But as soon as there's any snow coverage on it, then the amorphous panel has its benefits. I've got a spreadsheet which details all this, and I'll perhaps show you that in another viewing. Here is the other end of the panel, the power box. Basically, it's got a battery tender charger, so that if I'm actually using the power out of this box to run a cable modem for internet access and my wireless router. And if for any reason if the panels don't keep the batteries charged, then the battery tender kicks in and tops them up. The WhatsApp meters actually require independent power so they can keep their stats and figures. So they can run off the power they are monitoring, but to keep them more accurate and so they can keep their stats, I've actually got a separate solar charger, and I'm going to have a separate panel keeping those running. And then on the back of the box, I've got a little 12-volt panel, which is used often in yachts, just so that all the connections, panels, the controllers can be switched off and that they're fused for protection. And then we'll have a quick sneak peek inside. It's a bit of a bird's nest, but it's all...